finding the right cadence, the right pace of the bigger doses is tough. And it's an art, not a science. And you have to trust your intuition and then figuring out how to actually integrate it. And like, what's the action item for your integration? What does that mean for you? For me, it's been just pick one new habit and then try to and find a way to consistently embrace introspection. But it's a tricky one. It's a lot of work. This is not play. It's work. And I appreciate the way you just said that. Speaking of which, if you don't mind drilling down into one stab at the ineffable, which you kind of did already, but maybe a little bit deeper, I'll share briefly and I'll kick it to you. Pascal, I had an experience where one of my mentors is a very successful, accomplished guy. And he told me a story of when he was 4 years old. He was sitting, he slept in the same room as his six-year-old brother, who was his god, as oftentimes an older sibling is at that age, 4 years old. And he sat and watched as his six-year-old brother died with a asthma choking attack in front of him. And in my most recent trip on 3.5 grams of magic mushrooms, I don't know why, I don't know how, but it felt like I time traveled and experienced that entire scene. And it was vivid, like 4K HD. I was there. I experienced the scene from every angle. I experienced the scene of the perspective of the four-year-old watching his older brother die. I experienced the choking of the six-year-old as he died. And then I experienced it from some meta angle where it was like I could see the whole thing from a detached view. And I wept. And I still am kind of grappling with why I saw that, why I was there. And yet it was so vivid and moving. And it felt like time travel. It, not like I was, you know, I hopped in the DeLorean with Michael J. Fox or I jumped in the phone booth with Bill and Ted. It was more like my consciousness shifted. It's just like the consciousness bubble kind of moved over to this, you know, different segment of the multiverse, or in my mind, it recreated it with some neural signature. And it felt like, no, I was there. I saw it and I felt it. And I'm still, as you can tell, kind of working through it. Pascal, I'm curious for you, what is a mystical experience that still resonates?
Well, first, that must have been really challenging for you and possibly a bit cathartic as well. But I feel you. That sounds like a very challenging, potentially very challenging experience. So I feel that.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks for sharing. In terms of mystical experiences, I would say like there's one or two that resonates with me. And I've never been the type to do large doses because I'm quite sensitive. And I've realized along the way that I'm actually kind of like an earth a person, like very much in the ground, very action oriented, very kind of like to have my feet on the ground type of person. There is one experience that I would say like was the most mystical. It was my experience with 5-MeO DMT. That was very mystical for me because I was able to access levels of relaxation and bliss and just really connected with the thread of beauty and love to the point where my whole body was just resonating that energy. And I didn't see any, you know, mystical beings, and I didn't go into the other, you know, realms or multiverse or anything like that. But for me, it was very healing because I connected with a sense of joy that I had never been able to experience by myself. And so it removed all of the dirt and all the garbage that was kind of getting in the way of feeling joy in a very like deep felt sense. And I remember after the ceremony, people around me was like, "Hey, it looks like you lost 20 pounds. And I think I did. Like, you know, they say that you lose like 20 grams when your soul leaves your body. But I feel like I lost like 20 pounds of like trauma and stuff that I just didn't serve me anymore. And ever since then, I've been smiling a lot. I've been smiling and feeling joyful. So when I connect with you and I'm talking, I'm smiling. A lot of that came from that experience. And it wasn't visually mystical. It wasn't, you know, connecting with the aliens and, you know, the unicorns and all those things, but for me that was very mystical because it reduced a lot of the baggage that just wasn't serving me anymore, and connected me with bliss.